So now we're going to look at a couple really neat features. First, you're going to look back in our Google Classroom training sample site, and I'm going to say, what if I wanted to reuse this another way? And that was the one thing that we didn't talk about, was how to reuse a post. So I'm going to click here. I can go through any of my classrooms and pull something out. So let's say I want to pull something out of the AP Economics that Mr. Conti and I collaborated on last year, or a couple years ago. And I could select the class, and it pulls up every single post. Now you can see Mr. Conti did all the posting, but I could pull that, and I could even make new copies of all the attachments right by clicking that box right there. And I can reuse the post anywhere. That's really good, so I never lose anything. And that's one of the things, if I have an old course I archive, it doesn't really go away. Now you're saying, how do I archive a course? You simply come back to the main screen, you'll click here, hit archive, and it ends up down in the archive classes, just to keep it nice and clean. What if I want to hand in an assignment, and I want to be able to demonstrate to you what a student sees when they're able to hand in an assignment? So if I go over to here, this is the one I'm a student in, and you can see that we have an assignment. This is what the student would see. Here's the email assignment. This is just a test, and that way the other members can ignore this. And I'm going to click open. You notice it says not done, so it's managing for me what's done and what's not. And I can even look at my calendar, and I think he made December 12th as the due date. And there's the assignment, and if I click it, it pulls it right up here. Okay, so I can, here's the assignment. Now I can just mark it as done, which I'm not going to do. I'm going to go back, and I will open this up, and I can upload my Google Drive. I can create a Google Doc, so I will create something and say, and a Google Doc will open. And this will take just a second. And you can see it's got my name already on the top, which is helpful for the teacher. It also has the assignment name. So if you make it something unique, that's really good. So this is a test to see how to hand in some work. I've got it there. I say, this is some of my best stuff. Right here, it says turn in. That's a great button, because I don't have to go back and redo it. Automatically, I can just click it. You can see it says, would you like to turn in your work? One attachment will be submitted, and here it is right here. Turn in, and now it says done and gives me a big checkbox. That's a great way of making me feel more comfortable about what I've done. I look at my stream, the work is done, I've handed it in, and I could also reopen it if I really wanted to. And you can see here's all the work that we've talked about, and this is all of it collected in one place. So this is the true master feature of this, is that it allows you to look at one thing all in one place, and that really is super helpful to help keep you and your students organized. And this is stuff that you as a teacher would review, all the work that they've just submitted, and this is the stuff that's reviewed. So anything that you had reviewed, you would certainly go there. So that is the most advanced features of the assignment panes in Google Classroom.